Hello, everyone, and welcome to the Wellness Zone. Liver disease is a silent killer that affects millions of people around the world and can cause serious complications and even death if left untreated. But the good news is that most cases of liver disease can be prevented or treated if detected early enough. That's why it's crucial to know the signs and symptoms of liver disease and how to take care of your liver health. In this video, we'll explain what liver disease is, what are the stages of liver disease, and what are the 10 most common signs and symptoms of liver disease. We'll also share some interesting facts and statistics about liver disease that you may not know. So stay tuned till the end of this video to learn more about this vital organ and how to keep it healthy. So what is liver disease? Your liver is a large and powerful organ that performs hundreds of essential functions in your body. One of its most important functions is filtering toxins from your blood. While your liver is well equipped for this job, its role as a filter makes it vulnerable to the toxins it processes. Too many toxins can overwhelm your liver's resources and ability to function. This can happen temporarily or over a long period of time. When healthcare providers refer to liver disease, they're usually referring to chronic conditions that do progressive damage to your liver over time. Your liver has great regenerative powers, but constantly working overtime to restore itself takes its toll. Eventually, it can't keep up. Chronic liver disease progresses in roughly 4 stages: hepatitis, fibrosis, cirrhosis, and liver failure. Hepatitis means inflammation in your liver tissues. Inflammation is your liver's response to injury or toxicity. It's an attempt to purge infections and start the healing process. But when the injury or toxicity continues, so does the inflammation and can eventually result in scarring. Fibrosis is a gradual stiffening of your liver as thin bands of scar tissue gradually add up. Scar tissue reduces blood flow through your liver, which reduces its access to oxygen and nutrients. This is how your liver's vitality begins to gradually decline. Remarkably, some amount of fibrosis is reversible. Your liver cells can regenerate, and scarring can diminish if the damage slows down enough for it to recover. Cirrhosis. Cirrhosis is severe, permanent scarring in your liver. This is the stage where fibrosis is no longer reversible. When your liver no longer has enough healthy cells left to work with, its tissues can no longer regenerate. But you can still slow or stop the damage at this stage. Cirrhosis will begin to affect your liver function, but your body will attempt to compensate for the loss, so you might not notice at first. Liver failure. Liver failure is the final and most serious stage of liver disease. This is when your liver can no longer perform its vital functions and starts to shut down. Liver failure can be acute, sudden and severe, or chronic, gradual and progressive. The only treatment for liver failure is a liver transplant, which is a major surgery that involves replacing your diseased liver with a healthy one from a donor. Did you know? Your liver is the only organ in your body that can regenerate itself. That's right, your liver can grow back to its original size and function, even if up to 75% of it is removed or damaged. This amazing ability is due to the fact that your liver is made up of tiny units called lobules, each of which can function independently. However, this does not mean that your liver is invincible. If the damage is too extensive or chronic, your liver may lose its regenerative capacity and succumb to liver disease. There are many factors that can cause or contribute to liver disease, like alcohol, fat accumulation, etc. What are the signs and symptoms of liver disease? Liver disease can be tricky to diagnose because it often does not cause noticeable signs and symptoms until it is advanced. However, 10 of the common signs and symptoms of liver disease are: Symptom 1, jaundice. This is a yellowing of your skin and eyes due to the buildup of a substance called bilirubin in your blood. Bilirubin is a waste product that is normally removed by your liver. When your liver is damaged, bilirubin can accumulate and cause jaundice. Symptom 2, abdominal pain and swelling. This is a pain or discomfort in the upper right part of your abdomen, where your liver is located. It can be caused by inflammation, infection, or enlargement of your liver. You may also notice swelling or fluid buildup in your abdomen called ascites. Ascites is due to increased pressure in the blood vessels of your liver, which forces fluid out of the vessels and into the abdominal cavity. Symptom 3, swelling in the legs and ankles. This is due to fluid retention in your lower extremities, called edema. Edema is also due to increased pressure in the blood vessels of your liver, which reduces the amount of blood that returns to your heart. This causes fluid to leak out of the vessels and into the tissues. Edema can also be a sign of heart failure, kidney disease, or malnutrition. Symptom 4, nausea and vomiting. This is a feeling of sickness or discomfort in your stomach that makes you want to throw up. It can be caused by various liver problems, such as hepatitis, cirrhosis, or liver cancer. Nausea and vomiting can also be a sign of other conditions, such as food poisoning, gastritis, or pregnancy. Symptom 5, confusion and mood changes. This is a state of mental confusion or disorientation, and a change in your emotions or behavior. It can be caused by hepatic encephalopathy, which is a serious complication of liver failure. Hepatic encephalopathy occurs when your liver can't remove toxins from your blood, and they accumulate in your brain. This can affect your cognitive function, memory, concentration, judgment, and mood. You may also experience hallucinations, delusions, paranoia, or aggression. Another interesting fact. Did you know that your liver is the largest solid organ in your body? That's right. Your liver weighs about 3 pounds, 1.4 kilograms, and is roughly the size of a football. It is located in the upper right part of your abdomen, under your ribcage. Your liver is divided into two main lobes, the right lobe and the left lobe. The right lobe is larger than the left lobe and accounts for about 60% of your liver's mass. Symptom 6, tendency to bruise or bleed easily. This is due to a reduced production of clotting factors by your liver. Clotting factors are proteins that help your blood to form clots and stop bleeding. When your liver is damaged, it can't make enough clotting factors, which increases your risk of bleeding from minor injuries or cuts. You may also notice blood in your urine, stool, or vomit, or bleeding from your nose, gums, or eyes. Bleeding can also be a sign of other conditions, such as hemophilia, vitamin K deficiency, or leukemia. Symptom 7, fatigue and weakness. This is a feeling of tiredness or exhaustion that does not go away with rest or sleep. It can be caused by various liver problems such as anemia, low red blood cell count, hypoglycemia, low blood sugar, or hepatic encephalopathy, brain dysfunction due to liver failure. Fatigue and weakness can also be a sign of other conditions such as depression, thyroid problems, or chronic fatigue syndrome. Symptom 8, itchy skin. This is a sensation of itching or irritation on your skin that does not have an obvious cause. It can be caused by the accumulation of bile salts in your skin. Bile salts are substances that help your liver digest fats and are normally excreted in your bile. When your liver is damaged, bile salts can build up in your blood and deposit in your skin, causing itching. Itching can also be a sign of other conditions, such as allergies, eczema, or scabies. Symptom 9, dark urine and pale stool. This is a change in the color of your urine and stool due to the abnormal metabolism of bilirubin. When your liver is damaged, bilirubin can spill over into your urine, making it dark or brown. At the same time, bilirubin can be reduced in your stool, making it pale or clay-colored. Dark urine and pale stool can also be a sign of other conditions, such as dehydration, gallstones, or pancreatic cancer. Symptom 10, loss of appetite and weight loss. This is a lack of interest or desire to eat and a decrease in your body weight. It can be caused by various liver problems, such as nausea, vomiting, ascites, or liver cancer. Did you know that your liver has a close relationship with your brain? That's right, your liver and your brain communicate with each other through a network of nerves and hormones. Your liver can influence your brain function, mood, and behavior, and vice versa. For example, your liver can produce serotonin, a neurotransmitter that regulates your mood, sleep, and appetite. Your brain can also affect your liver function, such as by increasing or decreasing the production of bile, a fluid that helps your liver digest fats. This is why liver disease can cause mental and emotional problems, and why stress can worsen liver disease. That's all for today's video. I hope you learned something new and useful about liver disease and how to spot the signs and symptoms before it's too late. Remember, your liver is a vital organ that performs hundreds of essential functions in your body, so you should take good care of it and seek medical help if you notice any signs of trouble. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel for more informative and engaging videos. Thank you for watching, and see you next time.